Jess Maddren this morning from Corella Resources. Jess, good morning.
Thanks, Andrew.
You joined Corella a couple of months back as Chief Executive. Just give us firstly a bit of an introduction to Corella.
Yeah, Corella Resources is focused on some alumina, high-purity alumina projects and high-purity silica projects in Western Australia in particular, about a 3.5-4 hour drive northeast of Perth in the top end of the wheat belt.
You've put out this scoping study for the Tampu project in WA. Just give us a bit of a run through as to some of the key talking points.
Absolutely. It's a great kaolin project, and Australia's got quite a long history in kaolin, but it feels like the market's changing a little bit in this whole industrial minerals world, specifically in HPA and kaolin as well. So the project is kaolinized granite for the geologists that are on the call or watching the recording, but it's a very high purity alumina kaolinized granite where it's got very low contaminants in it, low iron in particular, and that's what makes it special for the HPA process, because the HPA process is all about your contaminants to get that high purity. So if you go in with low contaminants, you're more likely to come out with low contaminants at the end. But as the scoping study showed, is we did two end scenarios, a base case and a top end case. So one was if we only went with kaolin, and that was a 400,000, we kept the feed tons consistent from both scenarios, about 400,000 tons a year. That produced about 200,000 tons of kaolin for the year, and that had an NPV of just over $1 billion. And the IRR was about 78% as well, which is almost unheard of in mining projects this today. And then the HPA scenario, so same feed in, different ratio out of that plant, but that came in well over $4 billion. So the mine life of this is about 58 years, which is multi-generational in an area that has some declining other industries there. So it's great for the town and this old area of WA in a changing macroeconomic situation.
And I suppose, is it fair to say producing HPA from kaolin, that's not your traditional approach, is it?
No, it's not, not at all. Well, it's not today's market approach in there. So it's not saying that it can't be done. It absolutely can be done. There's lots of chemistry there showing that it can be done. But the global market for HPA wasn't a huge demand. So we've seen a real change in that demand for HPA and the uses for HPA, which is now accelerating. Well, where are these other sources? Particularly if you get a deposit like kaolin, where roughly 50% of it will be a silica of some sort of quality. So if you have high purity silica as well as high purity alumina, there are markets for that now, which is different to what it was 20 and 30 years ago when the HPA market was starting off in that chemistry or a Bayer byproduct feed in that. So there's real room for that. And again, it's down to that purity. If you have a high quality resource with low contaminants going into a chemical process, it's likely that you're going to have a lower capex and a higher purity out the other end with low contaminants.
And what about the market for kaolin? That's starting to build up.
Yeah, it's starting to change. We're seeing a few different dynamics. I mean, back in the day, kaolin came from China, the UK, and Georgia in the US. And like any resource we've been doing across the world, as you get declining grades, the high purity stuff is harder to find in there. The area that's in a little bit of an unusual situation around Russia and Ukraine, Czech, etc., makes it a little bit harder there. So where Australia's tried to go into kaolin, we're seeing such a change in this market driven by population increases in Asia, the multi-use of kaolin, depending on your purity and your specification, really starting to grow. So with other of my peer companies out there, we're seeing this demand grow. We're seeing enough space open up where you have differing products in kaolin and therefore a market demand that is driving the development of these mines going forward.
Are we seeing a fair amount of kaolin production or development within Australia now?
We are definitely seeing more than we've seen over the last 30 years. There are quite a few peer companies popping up, and particularly around WA. WA and South Australia, full of granite, so you're going to get kaolinized granites there. So it's the setting for it where you'll get long-term weathering down to a pure kaolin clay, depending on the composition of your starting granite there, which varies across Australia.
Well, look, just to be clear, you mentioned there's a number of companies within your peer group now. Just what makes Tampu stand out amongst them?
So it's our quality of our kaolin in there. It's the low contaminants, the low iron on a large resource. We also have access to some clear infrastructure. We have some freehold land out 2 kilometres from there with our own storage shed already there. So that's a good fast forward for it. Some of the specifications are coming back to specialty industrial style kaolin or consumer grade kaolin, which is a little bit different as well. So we'll see what pops out, but the kaolin markets is you can have 10 or so end users. Each of those have 10 or so specifications that sit underneath them. So there's lots of market out there depending on price, quality, specification, and the customers at the back end of that.
I realise the scoping study is just still hot off the press, but are you having some early offtake discussions?
Starting to get there. So our next step is going into the feasibility study. So the feasibility study, where I mentioned in the scoping study, we had the two end scenarios. The feasibility study is going to focus on what products can we produce, when, how, and why, what markets and potential customers are out there and why, and therefore what prices for the product, because if the scoping study was a blended basket price over the life of the mine, which I said was 58 years, a long time for an average price across a complicated industrials product basket. So that's what we're focusing on, the feasibility study. Let's get a little bit more refined. That'll tell us what plants we build, when, why, how, and going in, depending on what we put aside for the HPA plant as well. So, yeah, it's starting those offtakes is very important.
And you've got a couple of metallurgical test work programs also underway.
We are, and that's defining that product basket. So are we going to be in the porcelain end of the kaolin, or are we going to be up in the coating ends, paper coating ends, or are we going to be in the pharmaceutical and cosmetic end of specification? Like any products, geological or nature products, you're going to get a blend. So it's how many proportions of that do you actually have in your deposit to match the market.
In terms of getting this material out the ground, is it a fairly straightforward mining process?
It is. That's one of the beautiful things about it. It's only a few metres below the surface, looking like low chance of needing to do anything like a drill and blast there. So likely to be a really easy operation of digging through, putting to the processing plant. So again, the feasibility study will be looking at mining methods. So how can we get the mining cost down? Pretty low already, but the lower you get in that cost quartile, always helps in price pressure markets for products as well.
I suppose just bringing it back to that peer group discussion again, how does your market cap, how does your valuation compare?
So we're in the lower end of the market cap, which is unusual, but we were a little bit under the radar. So Corella Resources were just going through the process slowly without a lot of promotion until I came into the role. The scoping study, we put our mineral resource estimate out in the mid of this year. So until you wrap some real economics out there, you've got holes in the ground. It's geology. You don't really have something that's economic, that's a valuation. So across the peers, we're in the lower end there, but we might see some changes in that area because moving towards the project fast, I gave in the AGM some indications. We're looking at how can we be in operation, a kaolin operation, within 2 years to start producing cash back into the business? And that's what the feasibility study is going to focus on.
Really great to see you. Jess, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew.